It's official, we are busting this joint. A month and a half since we've hit the road, we were kind of waking up with some like uneasy feelings. I think a lot of excitement and a lot of unsurety on how it's gonna go, especially since a tree fell on the RV.
Have no fear, the coffee is here. Team Hanks?
Team Hanks?
Do we know how to do this again? Do we need to watch our video of how to take down the RV? Maybe we should quick watch that.
Just unplug the TV.
What do we say with the Hanks family? We're always just winging it. How do you guys normally do on travel days? Do you guys wake up full of excitement, get a good night's sleep the night before knowing that new adventures are coming? Or are you guys tossing and turning a little bit in bed, a little unsure of where things are gonna head the next day? I got the sewer unhooked, I got the water unhooked.
Woo!
And all I have to do is check tire pressures.
Woo! What is with the Hanks being ahead of schedule? Is it because we're hanging out with other people that
we could set behind? We're caravanning with our friends up to Indiana and we don't want to hold them back. So it gives you just that little extra drive to get things done early. So yeah. Last night I was trying to like stay on top of doing dishes, just dumping the tanks real quick one last time, all that stuff, so.
On a side note, we don't have any like lunches to pack for the day.
Nothing, huh?
I mean, I could just pack slices of bread. I just whipped together some graham crackers, cookies, and some leftover like Cheez-Its.
Wow, how satisfying of a lunch that's gonna be.
That's super healthy and better. I still don't wanna go pay for food.
I know, better than going out to eat. I'm sure we can hit a Walmart on the way.
Yeah, cause we have leftovers from yesterday to heat up. So if we get, the sooner we get there, the sooner we can eat our own food.
Okay, well, yeah. We get about 5.5 hour drive today. 7.5 hour. RV driving time. Have you noticed a trend with these new videos that they're getting more and more goofy as we go along? You guys might be thinking we're trying harder or just really trying to bring it on, bring that shock factor, but guess what? That's just the Hanks exposed. That's just us in our natural state of minds. Just prepare yourself. I mean, if you hit the subscribe button, you are prepared for what's to come with us. And yeah. We just kind of lay it all out on the table.
Sorry for the noise.
My ears.
I mean, our true colors are just coming out more and more. So what are you gonna do, huh? Somebody's really ready to go. I put his cage on top of the steps to get it ready, and I turn around and this is what I see. He got in the cage himself. Good boy, you ready to go bye-bye? I don't know if he realizes what he just did. So I'll tell you what we did last night. We got Dexter's cage out ahead of time, which I recommend if you're traveling with pets. The night before you're about to take a trip, have the cage out in the living room so they can get used to the cage. It's just so they can like smell it and get acclimated to it, because that's exactly what Dexter was doing all night. So now he feels very comfortable going into his cage and now he's ready to hit the road. Let's go see what Carl's up to. How's it going?
Good.
You excited to tow with your new tires?
Yeah.
The all-terrain.
So much better ride than the mud tires.
Yeah.
No doubt. I'm just about done with these and I'm gonna do the trailer tires.
We're gonna be good. We're all packed up on the inside and the slides, like, it's ready for slides.
That's not fair. They're all helping you. Who's helping me?
Who's helping me?
Everyone there.
Yeah.
They're all Team Renee, Team Nene right
yeah,
now.
Yeah, they're all cheering me on.
They're like, hey, leave Carl out there to do the tires. Yeah. Nobody wants to deal with that right now. I'm glad you guys are here now. We don't mess around in this family.
Oh boy.
All terrain.
You know what I'm really upset about is like I just had to unhook the super fast Wi-Fi that our awesome friends hooked us up with while we were here. I have to say goodbye to it and go back to full-time RV internet.
I am going to miss that. Definitely gonna miss
that. I know. I was saying my goodbyes.
300 megabytes a second. On to greener pastures though. You were saying the other day that I can't wait to get normal water pressure back.
That's
and then
true.
You're gonna miss the Wi-Fi though.
Yeah, and I was like, I'll take lower water pressure over Wi-Fi, over bad internet.
Me too. Good internet is the way to go. Do you want me to do my duties and
get up there? No leaf blower still? Nene didn't get you an electric leaf blower for your birthday?
No. But you got me a toilet and that's been working out so nice.
Yes.
I've been letting her rip. Every time I put this on, I feel like that dude off of Mary Poppins that goes cleans chimneys. You know what I'm talking about? Good day, Mary Poppins. I'm like gonna go up and go this way and actually sweep off the side.
Are just about ready to actually return to Hitchhike. Now this site that we've been at for like 2 months, it's on an incline, so low at the bottom and it goes up in the air. So we actually dropped our front jacks so low. It's gonna take us like so long to get back up to Hitchhike. Let me show you. Look at that.
Look at that spacing. This is how I have to get underneath here.
Come on in.
How far that got knocked off from the tree.
That tree wasn't messing around.
The tree was not messing around. I guess it hit the rear and it kind of like shifted the front. I kind of scooted it.
The back's gonna be like doing a wheelie touching the grass soon. I guess you could back up and I'll see how much further we need. Nice job.
Thanks. Thanks for having me. Bye.
Oh, I don't know if you are.
Now my wheels in motion and my windows open with the wind blowing in my hair. I'm driving down the highway. Don't I do this my way? I can feel it in the air.
The radio.
High five.
Here I go. What in the dickens? See what happens when you take a home and put wheels on it and you bounce down the highway? Things just, what the heck happened to the TV? And the skylight fell down again? Okay, this thing's falling apart. All right, it's crazy up in here. I bought new camping chairs today. It has been 4 years that we have been using the outdoor chair for RV, and we had the zero gravity chairs and we just were not into them anymore. I got some good ones. Wait till you see. Carl's gonna try them out for the first time. Let's see what he thinks. Wow, sir, do you have a license to operate that chair?
Wow, this is, ooh.
Do you like?
Me likey.
Now, I know you like to recline though and put your feet up, so I think you can end up buying like feet things.
Can you?
Oh my gosh, between that and your Coors Banquet.
Or like an old fashioned.
No!
Good day, how you doing?
You know, it just works.
You know, we're just at that stage where we need rocking chairs.
Look at these things, this is great. Look at, they got little shock absorbers here.
Yeah,
these are super snazzy. Yeah, these are actually really, really comfy. Thank you for taking care of this family and finding out what the true priorities of the Hanks household is.
Well, you know, you turned 30 recently, so I'm like, he needs an old man chair.
Low lumbar support.
Yes.
Like that.
I see how you are getting in and out of the zero gravity chairs, and my heart hurts for you.
I understand.
Because you have a hard time. Oh yeah? You want the heat? You want the heat? We'll take it anyway!
You can't take shortcuts with that. Yo, got it! Thank you so much.
We're gonna rock these rocking chairs so well. And guess where we get to use them first?
Where?
The rally.
The rally?
Yes.
How easily do they fold up?
Okay, let's see if you can figure it out. Let's see how easy it is.
Oh, nice. Look at that. And not heavy at all. Mama's tell ya, these are sweet.
How does it feel? Cause you said those zero gravities were like bulky to carry.
Yeah, they're way bulky, but now I could just throw a couple of these over my shoulder.
Okay, why is it around your neck? What's happening? Okay.
I thought this was a shoulder strap.
What am I gonna do with him? Take this off.
You carry it this way.
No way.
Look at that.
That is super.
Wow. Wow.
4 years for this, honey. Why are we just now learning all these things 4 years later? We got the toilet,
hey,
the chair, the Blackstone.
We're always learning. And you're always upgrading. Because 4 years ago, we were like zero gravity chairs.
Oh, they were huge hit back then. I mean, those were the luxury big papas in the game.
I don't want to feel like I have to like really... Do you guys agree if you have the zero gravity chairs, do you feel like to get out of them, you have to really be committed and just kind of get a head start and like... Rah.
Honestly, this is a lot to handle, isn't it?
Say it's not. Say I'm normal. I'm normal, right?
Did you check tire pressure?
You are so done. Get out. You're done. Privileges revoked.
This is insane. Legit insane.
I said I would never want a toy hauler, but come here.
Maybe it's time for an upgrade. I don't know. Send help.